Whitmore.
Hello, love. How are you?
In the smallest denim shorts I've ever seen.
Do you know what? They weren't this small, but I was sitting down for a while eating food, and then I got up and I realised I've lost half of them. So I need to do a bit of a de-wedge.
Do you want
to
go? I'll
I'm not going to do it right now because there's a camera watching.
Yeah, fair enough, though. But yeah, de-wedge those.
I'll de-wedge them.
You look good, though.
Thanks very much. Very I like your good. Red lipstick.
Hey,
I see someone else wearing red lipstick. I'm like, oh, I'm jealous. It looks
I'll
good.
I'll lend it you.
Thanks. Give
yeah,
a little bit of snog and we can swap.
I will snog your face off.
Oh, you're too kind. You're so kind. Thank you.
Red lipstick on you. You were here last night.
Yeah.
Did you stay over?
Yeah, we stayed over. We were filming yesterday because we were here with MTV. We were doing a few interviews.
Yeah.
Stayed and watched the script Beyonce. We got a lovely yurt backstage.
Okay, so you yurted it.
We yurted it. We glamped it.
How was that?
It was amazing. Do you know what? The yurt's probably better than my own bedroom at home. It was prettier. Good. There's a bit of a party going on there. A few guitars came out, a bit of a sing-song.
Lovely.
So, yeah, into the wee hours of the night.
So how are you feeling today? Are you fresh or are you?
Feeling fresher now because this place is amazing. I got up feeling and looking terrible. Walk through here, makeup, hair, you come out the other side and you feel great.
Like a car wash.
I feel like I've gone through a car wash.
Are you drinking? Have you drunk today?
Not today.
Do you want?
Okay.
A little tip.
Now, have you already had some of this? Because
yeah,
I might have done a bit of red lipstick here. I feel like you may already have been here. But
that's
thank
our
you.
Drink.
What
Laura.
Is that? It's our drink. We share it. Times are so tough. Yeah. We have to share the drink.
What is your festival tip?
You know, it's each to their own, really. Because I know some people get a bit bogged down with, I want to go see this band. Enjoy the day. And sometimes if you're with a big group of people and you try and go and see everything, it doesn't work.
Yes.
So I kind of split off. And if I want to see a band, I'll go off myself and do my own thing. Or I'll get one mate to come with me. If you're with five or six people, you just end up fighting about who you're going
to
go and
somebody
see.
Somebody wants to go to the loo and then someone else.
And then you're waiting and everything takes so long. And I'm a bit impatient. So I'm like, come on, guys.
What's your festival essential? What would you never come to a festival without?
Some baby wipes. Got some baby wipes in the bag.
Yeah.
Always good. Bit of a baby wipe shower.
Or would you baby wipe?
I baby wiped this morning.
Did you? When did you last have a wash, Laura?
Yesterday.
Yeah, of course you did. Niall's here.
He is.
Are you going to have to look after him? Are you going to have to keep an eye on him?
I think he can look after himself.
Okay. Because I was thinking, with my mates, you sort of see them go and you're like, right, this is the time. They need to go to bed.
Oh, he calmed down really early last night. He calmed down around like 2 or half 2. Well, let down.
Is he a bit
of a lightweight?
We
robbed his guitar, though. We brought him to the party. I hope he got it back.
Is he a bit of a lightweight?
No, he's... Do you know what? I don't know. Because I'm sure that when the guys go off on tour, I'm sure they can party enough for the rest of us.
They can. Doesn't bear thinking about, Laura. If you could share a festival tent with anyone, celebrity, who would you pick, Laura?
Ooh. Probably someone who's clean, to be honest with you.
Who would be clean?
Who's
a clean celebrity?
Who is a clean? Who looks like they're really clean in the celebrity world? Or Beyonce, because then I could like borrow clothes from her wardrobe.
Nice.
She had a lot of clothes last night, so a lot of different changes.
A lot.
So maybe Beyonce. And I'm sure she, with her entourage, she probably has a cleaner. Like a come in and clean the tent.
So it's very practical answer.
So I'll go with Beyonce.
Like it. Would you ever have sex at a festival?
Oh, no. Well, no.
Have you had sex in a tent?
No. Oh, at a festival? No. I think that, first of all, there's not a lot of privacy at festivals.
No.
And I think it's always important to be safe. I don't know. As it is, sleeping in a tent isn't very fun, let alone doing any other type of shenanigans.
Yeah. What's the worst thing you've ever witnessed at a festival?
Saw a girl at this festival 3 years ago take a shit in the middle of the fields up there.
No, Laura, it really upsets me that people...
She's proper squatting.
Yeah, she's there, squatting away. In a few hours, what are you most likely to be doing? Where would I find you?
Oh, in a few hours?
Yeah.
Probably bopping away to whoever's on stage, probably out in the crowd.
Who do you want to see?
Oh, God, well, I really want to see... Well, obviously, Kings of Leon I really want to see.
Yes.
Stereophonics are on. Who else? The Vaccines are playing. Do you know what? It's a really good eclectic mix this year. A
lot of boys. A lot of boys and guitars.
A lot of boys and guitars, which I absolutely hate, so...
Yeah, me too. It's awful, isn't it?
It's terrible. Terrible looking boys with guitars.
Who's the sexiest boy with a guitar here, do you reckon?
I better not say. Who's the sexiest boy here with a guitar? I don't know, I haven't seen enough boys with guitars. Maybe ask me that later on when I've seen a few.
Yeah, sure.
Any of the followers,
any of the followers. That's the
Caleb
thing.
Or Nathan on his bass. Or not Nathan on his bass, the other one, Jared on his bass.
Yeah, fine. Put you down for one of them.
Do you know what? I'll just take any of them. It's fine. They're all married anyway.